Hadi Om. Hi, everyone. My name is Zach. Welcome to this shorter integral yoga Hatha class. It will be about a 30-minute class today. The idea is hopefully to provide you with a template of sorts for creating your own shorter personal practice. It's always great if we have 90 minutes or 60 minutes to practice our Hatha yoga, but sometimes we don't have that time. And so we want to be able to have a complete practice, but in a shorter amount of time. And so this will be about a 30-minute practice, give or take. And before we get started, let me just say that in general, if you're trying to create your own complete, total, personal Hatha yoga practice, there are four basic kinds of asanas, of postures that are included in the integral yoga style of Hatha. And those are forward folds, back bends, inversions, and twists. So if you're ever trying to create your own practice, if you can include those four kinds of asanas, so again, back bends, forward folds, inversions, and twists. If you can include at least one of those in your practice, then that will feel very complete through your body, through your nervous system. You'll find a sense of balance and depth with that. And as we get started, I invite you to consider the love that you feel for the people closest to you in your life. It may be a child or a parent or a significant other or a best friend. Consider how you like treating them, the kinds of ways that you engage with them. Consider that for a moment. And then try to treat yourself the same way, with the same love, the same affection, the same care. And I think that's a good way of approaching this class and every class, being able to adapt and modify in the way that suits you best, because you love and care for yourself. Let's begin in a comfortable seated position. It may be legs crossed. You may be in a kneeling position or in a chair, whatever is most comfortable for you. Take a moment to sit comfortably. You can close the eyes if that's comfortable for you, or gaze downward. Have a few slow, deep breaths. And we'll chant the primal sound Om three times. Inhaling for Om. 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 Remain seated. We'll continue with netra vyayamam, some gentle eye movements. You can remove any glasses if you're wearing them. Focusing at the eyes, we'll open the eyes and gaze up and down, swinging the eyes up and down in a smooth, comfortable motion. Keeping the head still, moving only the eyes, giving them a nice stretch in either direction. Now centering the eyes and closing, having a breath in and out. Open. opening the eyes once more, this time gazing to the right and the left, right and left, continuing at your own pace. These very simple eye movements can be very effective at reducing eye strain, especially with the amount of time we spend on screens nowadays. Centering the eyes once more now, closing, inhaling, and exhaling. Bringing the hands together and rubbing the palms to create heat. When you have a good amount of heat between the hands, cupping the palms over the closed eyelids, letting them bathe in this warmth, relaxing the muscles around the eyes. And then releasing the hands down to the lap, we'll begin to make our way to a standing position in the way that's most comfortable for you. You can set any props to the side. And we'll be meeting at the front of our mat in a standing pose, preparing for just a couple rounds of sun salutations. You may like to have some gentle movements loosening the body as you come into your standing pose. Eventually finding the feet parallel. They can be hips width distance or closer if that's comfortable. Lift up through the arches of the feet. You can feel a slight lift in the kneecap, helping to engage through the quads. The chest is lifted and open, shoulders relaxed. The back of the neck is long, and the crown of the head is lifting slightly towards the ceiling. And just a reminder, please feel free to adapt, modify in any way that is most suitable for your body today. Exhaling the palms together at the heart. Inhaling the arms out, up and back, pressing the feet down as you arch back. And on the exhale, releasing forward, forward, fold. The knees can bend or remain straight, releasing the head and neck here. Stepping the left foot back into a low lunge position, lowering the knee, extending the spine. Exhaling the right foot back, downward facing dog. You can take a moment here, bending one knee and then the other. But eventually have a moment of stillness, the hips lifting high and the heels lowering down. Now releasing the knees, chest and chin to the mat. Pelvis remains lifted, sliding forward, lifting head, neck, and chest, baby cobra, and exhaling back to downward facing dog. The back of the neck is long, the hips are lifted. Inhaling the left foot forward, low lunge on this side, extending the spine as the pelvis releases. Stepping the right foot forward, forward fold. Always feeling free to let the knees be bent or straight. Inhaling to sweep the arms and torso out, up and back. Exhaling the palms together at the heart and releasing the arms. And we'll have one more round here. Exhaling the palms together. Inhaling the arms out, up, and back. Exhaling to release forward, forward fold. Stepping the right foot back this time, low lunge. And stepping the left foot back, downward facing dog. Pressing firmly into the hands, into the fingertips, and the base of the knuckles. Releasing knees, chest, and chin to the mat. Sliding forward into a baby cobra, head, neck, and chest lift. Exhaling, downward facing dog. On the inhale, stepping the right foot forward, low lunge. And the left foot steps forward, forward fold. Inhaling to sweep torso out, up, and back. Exhaling the palms together at the heart, pausing for just a moment, and releasing the arms. You can have the eyes closed, noticing how the body feels. Let's make our way down to the mat now, moving comfortably. You may like to lower one knee down and then the other, turning to lie on the back for just a moment in Shavasana. Arms and legs a comfortable distance apart. Completely relaxing. Let the body be heavy. Rolling onto the abdomen now. You can have the cheek to one side, or you can have the forehead stacked on the hands. So there's one option, or the cheek to the side. Placing the forehead down now and the palms under the shoulders, maybe slightly back from the shoulders, an inch or two, preparing for Bhujangasana, the cobra pose. Exhale fully, and on the inhale, extend the head, neck, chest, lifting up, bringing the shoulder blades back as if they were going to touch one another, breathing into the upper back, keeping the awareness focused between the shoulder blades. You're welcome to come down when it's comfortable for you, or you can remain here for another few breaths, drawing the elbows back, exhale and slowly lower chest, chin, and forehead, turning the cheek to the other side, relaxing the arms and legs apart. Bringing the forehead back to the mat, this time extending the arms overhead, exhaling fully, and on the inhale, extending through the feet and the hands, lifting up through both limbs, all limbs rather, soaring through the air here while balancing on the belly. You're welcome to stay here, or if you're comfortable in Dhanurasana, the bow pose, you can move into that. But it's perfectly fine to stay with the arms and legs extended, focusing on the extension as much as the lift. With control, exhaling and releasing down, arms and legs beside the body, cheek to the side. Bringing the palms under the shoulders now and pressing up onto hands and knees. Take your time and sit the hips back over the heels into child's pose. Without rush, moving comfortably and smoothly, releasing the forehead down. Lifting the torso upright now and sitting the hips to one side so that the legs can come forward, preparing for Paschimottanasana, the full forward fold. You may like to have a prop under the sits bones. I prefer a blanket myself to help lift the hips and help maintain a more natural curvature in the spine. You're also welcome to have the knees bent or straight here. Inhale the arms towards the ceiling, lifting up, and on the exhale, release forward. Whenever you notice the back begin to round, simply let the hands release down wherever they naturally come, We'll be staying here for a minute or two. So no rush to get anywhere in particular. Relaxing and releasing with steady, smooth breaths. See if you can release a little bit more with every exhalation. Checking the jaw and the shoulders to see if they can soften. If you notice the mind wandering away, try to gently bring it back, staying focused on the sensations in the body, the sensations through the breath. And using the palms down on the floor, walk the hands back towards the hips to lift the torso up. Turn and lie on the back once more in Shavasana. Arms and legs a comfortable distance apart. And we'll be moving into the inversion practice now. You're welcome to find a position with the legs up the wall or resting on a chair or couch. I'll be instructing shoulder stand Sarvangasana. So if you'd like to practice shoulder stand, it's recommended to use a blanket under the shoulders. So you can have a blanket unfolded as such. And the idea is to have the shoulders on the blanket and then the head and neck coming off of the blanket. This helps to add some space in the cervical curve and be a little more advantageous for your body's well-being. You can come to lie so that the shoulders are on the blanket, the head is coming off the blanket. You may like to tuck your shirt in. And with the palms down on the floor, press the palms down and engage the core to swing the legs up and overhead, bringing the hands to the low back for support and lifting the legs up towards the ceiling. And you're welcome to come down at any time, or if you need to make an adjustment, it's nice to bend the knees towards the forehead, adjust the hands or the shoulder position, and then re-extend the legs. Have the focus at the base of the throat where the thyroid gland is being toned and massaged in this pose. The blood flow from the feet and legs are able to be reversed and drained down. The lymph, which is very central to our immune system, is able to drain. And also all of the digestive organs are able to relax out of their normally accustomed pockets. if it's comfortable and there's time, it's nice to stay in inversions for about 3 minutes, because that's the amount of time that it takes for the body to circulate a full cycle of blood through the body. For today's practice, we'll begin coming down now, taking your time and lowering in the same way that you lifted, in the reverse order. And as the legs begin to come down to the floor, engage the core and slowly, with control, have the legs lower to the floor with control, engaging the inner thighs towards one another to help maintain that control. And once you've lowered down, you can take a moment of relaxation and then remove the blanket that was underneath and set it to the side, meeting in Shavasana once more. Whenever we practice shoulder stand, it's nice to have this counter pose, Matsyasana, fish pose. You can bring the legs together and slide the fingertips under the thighs or buttocks. Pressing the elbows down, inhale and sit halfway up, lifting the chest up and releasing the crown of the head down towards the floor. Expanding the base of the throat, the upper chest, taking deep, full breaths here. And let the shoulders be relaxing away from the ears. Very cleansing pose for the respiratory system. On the next inhale, pressing into the elbows to sit halfway up once more, and then release down to Shavasana. Arms and legs a comfortable distance apart. Extending the arms overhead, giving the body a good stretch in both directions. And we'll be coming to a seated position. You can roll to the side and press up, or you can engage through the abdomen and sit up from here. Coming into a twist now. You may like to sit on a blanket once more. Starting with the legs extended for Ardha Matsyendrasana. Keep the left leg extended, bending the right knee and hugging it in towards the chest, sitting tall, stepping the right foot over the left leg. This leg can remain straight or you can bend it in. Whichever position you have the leg in, you want to be firmly rooted in your seat. Take the right hand and place it behind the low back. Inhale to sit tall, and on the exhale, twist to the right, starting from the base of the spine and working up through the chest, shoulders, neck, and head. Find a position where you can comfortably hold for a few breaths, remaining focused on the length of the spine. On the exhale, releasing to center. And we'll switch to the other side. So the right leg is extended now. The left knee bends towards the chest and steps over the right leg, feeling that your seat is firmly rooted down. The left hand comes behind the low back. Inhale to sit tall and exhale to twist to the left. You may like to imagine a spiraling sort of energy moving up the vertebra, twisting to the left, lifting and twisting. And moving this upraised thigh, the left thigh in this case, towards the chest can be a nice point of reference. This helps to increase the detoxification effects happening through the kidneys and the adrenal glands. Exhale and return to center. Let's hug both knees into the chest, sitting tall, helping to reset the pelvis to neutral. And now sit in a comfortable cross-legged position for yoga mudra. If half lotus or the lotus pose is in your practice, this is a good time for that. And from your comfortable seated position, you can also be in a kneeling position or in a chair if that's most comfortable for you. Let's take the hands and bring them behind the back, clasping one wrist with the other hand. Inhaling to sit tall and exhaling to release forward.
Awareness within, relaxing everything. Using a slow inhale to extend the torso out and lift up.
Turning to lie in Shavasana for a brief period of relaxation. We'll be resting for just 3 or 4 minutes. Letting the arms and legs be comfortable. You may mentally do a scan of the body, moving from the toes, the feet, up through the lower legs and upper legs, relaxing them. Relaxing through the fingertips, the hands, wrists, forearms and upper arms. Relaxing the abdomen and low back, the ribs, chest and upper back, relaxing the shoulders, neck, jaw, the face, and the top of the head. And we'll rest in silence for a couple minutes.
Begin to have small movements through the toes and fingers, turning the head side to side. Rolling to one side, letting the body rest here for a moment. And then returning to a comfortable seated position. As you return to your comfortable seated position, feel that you are firmly rooted down. Have the eyes closed if that's comfortable, and begin to have slow, deep breaths, allowing the abdomen to expand with the inhalations and soften with the exhalations. Let's share one soft om together, leading into a brief period of silent meditation. Inhaling. Om. You can join me for the closing peace chant if you would like. Loka samasta sukino bhavantu. May the entire universe be filled with peace and joy, love and light. Jai Shri Satguru Maharaj ki. Victory to that light. Jai. Om Shanti. Thank you all very much. There isn't time for this short practice for longer pranayama or meditation, but if you're at home, it's always encouraged and recommended to have more time than we did just now for some pranayama and meditation, perhaps longer period for relaxation if that's available. But I hope you enjoy this practice. I hope you find it helpful for using as a template, perhaps, for your own personal home practice. And we'll see you next time. Om Shanti.